This video is sponsored by Unity. What's up game developers, CouchFerret here, and today we're gonna talk about prefabs, which is one of the essential building blocks of Unity. We'll cover what is a prefab and how to use them. Then we'll look into some more advanced topics like prefab instance overrides, prefab variants, and nested prefabs. Let's roll the intro. This video is a bit special because I wrote it after I went through the Building Complex Objects with Nested Prefabs course on Unity Learn Premium. Unity Learn Premium is Unity's official online learning platform, which has over 500 tutorials in structured learning paths to help you upskill and reach your goals. So if you want to learn more about prefabs, then take a look at Unity Learn Premium and check out the course I took. Due to the current crisis, Unity Learn Premium is free until June 20th, so it's the perfect time to give it a try, the link is in the description. What I really liked about taking this course is that next to the step-by-step tutorials, it also has a video recording of one of the live sessions they had with a Unity certified instructor. These sessions are interactive learning sessions where you work with an instructor on a specific topic and you can ask questions and get feedback. As you can see, for this month, they have a lot of interesting topics. So give Unity Learn Premium a try, the link is in the description. And thanks to Unity for supporting this channel. Okay, what's a prefab? A prefab is a template that you can use to create a lot of copies of the same object. And what's clever about it, that all of those copies will be connected to the prefab, so when you edit the prefab, all those copies will be edited as well. For example, if you want to create an enemy type in your game, by using a prefab, you can edit all of its copies simultaneously, and you don't have to go through them one by one. But let's jump into Unity and I'll show you. I'm using the Battle Royale pack from Polygon, the link is in the description. Okay, let's grab the mercenary male character, and without prefabs, we would just duplicate him a bunch of times like this. But the problem in this case is that when we want to change this character in our game, we have to edit them one by one. For example, if I want to give them a helmet, I have to go through them individually. And adding the helmet to one of the copies won't change the rest. This issue makes the process of editing the mercenaries really time-consuming. And this is where a prefab can be a huge time-saver. So let's see how to create prefabs. We can create prefabs out of game objects by dragging and dropping them from the hierarchy window into the project window. This will create a new asset file in our project. Unlike game objects, prefabs live in the project instead of the scenes. You can think about prefabs as if they were a saved and stored version of game objects. We can edit them by selecting them and in the inspector window hitting open prefab, or just double clicking them. This changes our current scene view to prefab mode and here's our prefab in it. Prefabs consist of game objects, the components on those objects, and the values of the components. But let's go back to the scene, we'll edit prefabs later. We can go back by clicking the arrow icon or the scenes here. So this new mercenary male asset in our project window is a template for mercenaries. It's a prefab asset and if you drag and drop it into the scene, Unity creates a prefab instance. As you can see in the scene window, there's not much of a difference between the prefab instance and the simple duplicates. But if you take a look at the hierarchy window, you can clearly see that the prefab instance has a blue icon, whereas the simple duplicates are just ordinary game objects with a transparent cube icon. Also, the one we used to create the prefab asset also turned into a prefab instance. We can create as many instances as we want by dragging them into the scene or into the hierarchy window, but duplicating an existing prefab instance works too. Now let's see the magic. I'm gonna add a helmet to all the prefab instances by changing the prefab asset. Let's copy this helmet game object and open up the prefab asset. You can also go to the prefab mode by clicking the arrow icon next to the prefab instances. Let's paste the helmet and position it. I'm gonna reset its position and move it up a bit on the y-axis. Something like this. Okay, let's go back to the scene. As you can see, now all the prefab instances have a helmet. We didn't have to go through them individually and add a helmet to them. The change we made in the prefab asset took care of it. Making our mercenaries into prefab instances created a connection between them, however, we can still tweak them individually to create a bit of variety. Let's add a beard to the first one. I'm gonna make this beard game object into a child object of the mercenary by dragging it into him. Now let's reset its position and move it up a bit. As you can see, only this one has a beard for now, and it didn't change the rest of the prefab instances. Now, in the hierarchy window, the beard game object has a plus sign on its icon, meaning that it's an instance override. An instance override is a modification on a prefab instance. It can be game objects, added or removed components, or changes in the component's values. Having instance overrides doesn't change the fact that the prefab instance is connected to the prefab asset. So if I go back to the mercenary prefab asset and change something, it's still gonna affect all the prefab instances, even the one with the beard. But if we really like this beard instance override, we can apply it to the prefab asset and by that roll it out to the rest of the prefab instances. Let's select the bearded prefab instance, and in the inspector window under the overrides drop-down menu, we can see all the current instance overrides on this prefab instance. Here we can apply or revert them one by one, or just apply all. Let's apply this beard instance override to the mercenary mare prefab asset. Boom! Now all the prefab instances have a beard. And if I open up the prefab asset, the beard is there. But let's undo it. Instead of applying the beard to all of them, we'll create a prefab variant, so we'll have mercenaries with and without beard. We only need to drag and drop this bearded prefab instance into the project window and select prefab variant. This creates a prefab variant asset in the project. Prefab variants act the same way as simple prefabs, they are stored as assets and you can create prefab instances out of them with the same connection. However, a prefab variant has an additional connection with its base prefab, the prefab we use to create the variant. To see the connection between the base prefab and the prefab variant, let's add a gun to the original prefab. I'm gonna copy and paste this gun and I'm gonna position it to his back. Okay, let's go back to the scene. Now, because the bearded prefab variant is based on the original mercenary prefab, not only the original mercenary prefab instances have a gun, but also the variant instances as well. And this is really cool because we can create and edit similar enemy types in our game without going through them one by one. And the prefab variant can be based on another prefab variant and so on, so you can build as many levels of connections as you want. However, there will be cases when the prefabs we want to connect won't be similar enough to have them in a prefab variant relationship. For example, if we want a silly hat on all of our characters in our game, both on the male and female mercenaries, but the female mercenary also has its own prefab, so prefab variants won't work this time. But we could just create a silly hat prefab and add it to both the male and female mercenary prefabs. This prefab in a prefab thing called nested prefabs. This might have sounded obvious and intuitive, but it was a long-awaited feature in Unity for years. Okay, let's create a prefab out of this silly hat. And let's add it to the mercenary prefabs. Cool, now everyone has a silly hat. The main reason we wanted this hat to be a nested prefab is that if in the future we want to make the hat even sillier, we can just change the silly hat prefab and it will be changed in the mercenary prefabs as well. Let's see it in action. I'm gonna add a few extra things to the silly hat prefab. And if I go back now to the scene, both the male and female mercenaries have the sillier hat. This way, no matter how many different characters are using this silly hat, all of them will get the update on the new look. And that's why nested prefabs are so powerful and could save us a lot of hassle. And you can also have multiple levels of nesting. I mean, a prefab can contain a nested prefab that contains another nested prefab. And this will be really helpful when you are putting together really complex objects like buildings. That's it for today, folks. If you want to learn more about Unity's prefab system and its capabilities, then check out the Building Complex Objects with Nested Prefabs course on Unity Learn Premium. Unity Learn Premium is free until June 20th, the link is in the description. And huge thanks to all the awesome Patreon supporters. Thank you guys. See you next time.